Hi everyone, if you reached out this video, you might heard about the cross-entropy or already using cross-entropy for your deep learning model optimization. In this video, let's clearly understand what is the cross-entropy and what is the intuition behind. Let's get it started. Long story short, cross-entropy is optimal entropy when the information can be incorrect. Wait a second, how the information can be incorrect? Well, the information can be incorrect if the information is from your estimation, prediction, or inference, just like classification output from your machine learning model. In other words, the cross-entropy is optimal entropy when the information is from estimated probability. You can easily find estimated probability from the softmax output of your deep learning model, and you might already have minimized the cross-entropy to optimize your deep learning model. It is okay to skip this slide even if you don't quite understand cross-entropy yet, but just remember, in order to calculate cross-entropy, we need softmax probability, which are yellow circles here, and the real true probability, which are green circles here. I will denote yellow circles as Q and the green circles as P here. And here is the cross-entropy equation. As you can see from this comparison, cross-entropy is just like entropy equation, but we have Q instead of P in the log values denominator. If you remember from my previous entropy videos, here PI is the probability distribution, and here log value is the amount of the info. You should have questioned that why Q for the amount of the information and why P for the probability distribution. From previous video, we understood the entropy is the information expected value, and the log 1 over probability stands for the amount of the info for each class. From expected value perspective, we should use true probability distribution for the probability of current information. Then, what about the real information of your event? Your real information from the prediction is the softmax output, so we use Q as log values denominator. By calculating in this way, we can get the optimal entropy from the model's prediction. When prediction is totally wrong, the cross-entropy value will be infinity, as you can see the calculation in this slide. If the prediction is similar to the true probability distribution, the cross-entropy is similar to the entropy. When the prediction is exactly same with the true probability distribution, the cross-entropy value is just same as the entropy. Mathematically, cross-entropy can be higher than the entropy. Intuitively, it makes sense since the cross-entropy is the amount of the information or uncertainty from given estimated information which is more uncertain than the entropy from the real probability distribution. Well, we already saw this cross-entropy value has ranged from the infinity to the zero, and actually the values are continuously decreasing when the prediction gets more similar to the true probability here. This is why we use cross-entropy as cost function of the deep learning model classification training. From this slide, you can see the cost is very high. Using gradient descent, we can reduce the cost until we reach it to the minimum. Gradient descent will update deep learning parameters, and then in the middle of the training, you can find the slope is less than the beginning. And when the training is successful, done, the cross-entropy will be nearly zero if the train converged well. This means that the deep learning model now optimized and the model prediction is most likely correct. Thanks for watching, and I hope this video helped you understand cross-entropy. Thank you very much.